With three nationally ranked teams, Creighton Athletics is building their program in more ways than one.
The Rasmussen Center is a facility on the Creighton University campus. It's a shared facility between campus recreation and athletics.
As the campus continues to expand into downtown Omaha, the need for a workout facility on the east end of campus became more obvious.
One portion has all our weight machines, our free motion machines. People that are looking to do kind of circuit kind of workouts kind of lean toward that end of the building, which is the south end. Our cardio equipment itself is in the middle area with the various treadmills, stair climbers, stair steppers, etc. And then on the far end of the building, that's where we have our free weights and weight benches.
Upon entering, students and faculty know they're in a state-of-the-art facility.
Yeah, it's kind of the newest in technology. I think all of us that went to college at one time or another were always instructed, bring your ID card, bring your ID card. And if you've ever been stuck on a 40 below degree day and having to walk back to your residence hall to find your ID card because they're not going to let you in the recreation center. So we found that we looked through the various technologies because we wanted to find a way so we could allow our students in just for that fact.
The new facility also gives the Creighton soccer, baseball, and softball programs an indoor workout facility, a huge benefit, especially during Nebraska's sometimes harsh winters. It's a benefit that, according to Bruce Rasmussen, will show its merits as coaches hit the recruiting trail.
Oh, without question. You know, you're talking about student athlete welfare, and now we can show that we can take care of them year round.
In 2009, when the plans were announced for the new Fitness, Health, and Recreation Center, it came as no surprise what the new facility would be called.
Well, as I told people, it's awkward to walk across campus with, while you're still working there and see your wife's name on a building.
Rasmussen, a respected coach and athletic director, has been with Creighton for more than 30 years, the last 18 as athletic director. Since becoming AD, Creighton has won 22 regular season and 29 conference tournament titles. All of this leads to 56 postseason appearances. Creighton has also been recognized with the Missouri Valley Conference All-Academic Award in 6 of the last 7 seasons.
I don't know of any job that's more dependent on others than an athletic director. You know, you need to have outstanding coaches, outstanding student athletes, you need to have support. Not only from your athletic staff, but across campus, from faculty and from staff and from the administration. You have to have support from the community, because no matter what we want to do in athletics, if people aren't willing to go beyond their jobs and families and make a commitment to you, because your entertainment and donation dollars, you can't get done what you want to get done. So I think it's a statement for a lot of people, and it shouldn't be my name on the building, it should be everybody who has helped make our program what it is.
Creighton Athletics continues to make a national splash. Creighton Soccer making its second straight appearance in the College Cup. CU Volleyball, fresh off winning the Missouri Valley title, made waves in their second NCAA tournament. And top 25 Creighton men's basketball continues to gain national press.
You know, I think the Kyle Korver's senior year, we had quite a bit of national publicity. But, you know, potentially we could have a good year, but we all know what potential means. Potential means you haven't done it yet. And so you have to learn how to handle it right. And you know, my grandpa used to say, a full bucket's hard to carry. You know, sometimes it's easier to carry that empty bucket where you're chasing rather than the team being chased.